Senator Cry has been spotted. Alright, Care Summer is finally here. I know I just ran into a door with popcorn on the entry, but I am fine because I am so motivated for Tropical Rouge, I'm gonna try and make a lot of Tropical Rouge puns. Sound good enough for this video, especially for the first episode. Anyways, this is my first Precure review, so I better take it well. Mine might not be weekly than others, but I'll do my best to tell you about my thoughts on it. As you saw from my running into a door. Yeah, watch out for doors if you're excited for something new. Anyways, let's get started with my review on Tropical Rouge Episode 1. Now the episode begins with Cure Grace's predecessor, Natsumi Natsu, as she is leaving her island home to live with her mother in the city and explore new things. She packs a big suitcase of stuff and clothes, something I would never be able to accomplish. My mom would kill me if I brought stuff like that on vacation. Well, technically she's not going on vacation, but if it were me and it was vacation, yeah, my mom would kill me. Not literally, just saying for reference. To an angry mom. Then it leaves her with her departure, saying goodbye to all the lion locals and her dad. She leaves on a small ship and is full of motivation. It then cuts to Laura in Grand Ocean as she is with the Queen and is tasked to find human with a burst of sunlight that will open the compact that is given to Laura. As Laura will need to find a human in order for it to work and to save the kingdom. And Laura, being the queen of faces, is like, if she completed, will she become the next queen? And Hinaka is doing such a good job by far at this point. Anyways, on my thoughts of the opening, though I have already seen it thanks to YouTube, here's what I thought of the opening that I wrote in my Precure notebook. So, I think the Tropical Rouge OP is, the song is really great and seasoning all of the characters that will make their reappearance in Tropical Rouge. We got the adults and the students in Natsumi School that I pretty sure will make their reappearance, I don't know. And of course, the remaining of characters and the glossiness of the backgrounds are so great. And Asuka got some great muscles. And I just love Minori's poker face. Oh my god, it's gonna be the best. I can't really say much about Sango, but she is really cute in fashion. The opening was definitely colorful, and I loved the twerking. Like, seeing that for the first time was a bit awkward, but enough. So, Natsumi gets to Aizora City, is greeted by her mom, who works at the aquarium. And we meet the director of the aquarium, Mifune Hiribayashi. Natsumi's mother lets her go explore the city, and we see Natsumi visit Pretty Holic and see Sango for the first time in the shop. They didn't talk to each other compared to the last season, which was Healing Good's first episode, but this is being used in episode 2. Sorry if you're hearing my parents in the background arguing. No, wait, that's just my sister arguing with my mom. Hear that in the background, I'm sorry. Anyways, Natsumi meets Laura and the Queen of Faces begins her role. First, she thinks Laura drowned when making her escape, but she got stuck in a heart-shaped rock and Natsumi had to pull her out. And boy, when Natsumi sees she is a mermaid, be like, dang girl, here we got our favorites in anime. When they get one character that's going all crazy and stuff, and then you got the other character that's like standing in silence, and the music just like cuts off and comes silent. It reminds me so much of Persona Dream Movie 2 when Aiga's just shot down Akihiko and Junpei's pickup lines so much. Oh my god. And just like a long name of Fuwa, Laura has that too. When talking to Laura, Laura remembers in order for her to become the next queen of Grand Ocean, she must find the pretty cure, which Laura daydreaming left with us what I'm gonna call the mermaid tail strangle. Yeah, she strangled Natsumi with the tail. Laura is very strong with her tail. Don't mess with her. Anyway, she asked Natsumi if she could open the compact, and Natsumi tried but couldn't, so Laura left and Natsumi went back to exploring again and went to the house she will be staying at with her mom. This is when Laura gets attacked by the first monster of the series that's called the Yarneeda. After witnessing it steal the motivation of some people who were doing exercises on the beach, and we meet First General Chungir. When seeing the face of the Yandere for the first time, geez, the face when it was like taking all the motivation power was like scary to me. It looked kind of like an evil palm tree more than when it was making that face, the naked little cutie one with the face that it made before. In the rays, Natsumi like heard Laura cry for help and she ran over. She was like attacking the Yandere without powers but fails, but her motivation wouldn't let her down. And for one part, I found that was funny that when Natsumi was just interrupting on here make his like evil speech plan about taking motivation, and soon Natsumi awakens to a crowd and transforms into Cure Summer for the first time. Now let's talk about Cure Summer's transformation. It was so colorful. The reflection of the mirror in the tropical pack reminds me of the Kira Kira pre-Cure transformation form, and the music in the background was so catchy. And when she says her speech, exciting everlasting summer, Cure Summer, the jump in the background was well done with that festive theme song when she jumped in. Oh my god, it was like so great. I love her transformation. So festive. Now, Cure Summer's fight is very different from other Pretty Cure fights for the first time. She is not all panic than other leads. As leads for the first time when they start fighting the monsters, they are like surprised that they transform and such. Or just like running away. But no, Cure Summer, she's something else. She was so determined to save Laura that she gave that Yandere a whooping. And when they tried to steal her motivation, it didn't work. Like, I think it was because of her pre-care powers, but anyway. And so, Cure Summer had a lipstick from her mom, which I forgot to mention that she dropped it in the ocean when she was on the boat going to the city, and Laura found it. The lipstick becomes the Heart Rouge Wad, and Summer performs her first attack. Now, I like how Summer's attack makes it look like she's blowing on bubblegum, and it becomes a sun, and she draws Ontario Summer's strike at the Yandere, and with that victory, she defeats the Yandere and turns it back into its vision form of palm tree. Laura was able to use the mermaid aqua pot to get the motivation back to the people who were exercising that concrete in concrete trees. Like, this scene was really well done. And like, it was so colorful too with the explosion. It was like a firework. And the way how she like, Summer said, victory! Really was unique. Definitely something I've never really saw in Pretty Cure before. At the ending, Laura explains more about Pretty Cure to Natsumi off screen and that she is gonna have to fight more of those monsters. And then Laura goes back to daydreaming of becoming Queen of Grand Ocean, which Natsumi was trying to ask her more questions on what she meant about fighting as Pretty Cure. Oh, she's gonna be a handful as a mascot, isn't she? And then, like, after that part, we get a look at the villain's hideout, and Butler, the seahorse, is informing the Witch of Procrastination of the issue with the Pretty Cure. And lazy as she is, she says to deal with it late tomorrow. Which I say that's actually really good on our character because, like, she's procrastination, so she's lazy. Especially her design is like, she definitely looks like a little bit like a sea slug of Ursula in The Little Mermaid. That's what it looks like to me. I bet everybody's gonna call her Ursula on the internet. Probably is. Okay, this was a very first exciting for the first episode of Tropical Rouge. Like all Percure first episodes, they always are exciting. And I also am so happy to see it, as if you remember of me running into a door. Anyways, from what I see in episode 2, Natsumi is gonna meet Sangha at school, and Laura is gonna follow her, and get spotted by one of the students. So let's hope she doesn't get captured and sent off to some lab. She's our little BJ, anyways. I hope you enjoyed this review, and bye-bye, because I'm gonna try and do more of these. I might not be good at it, but hang on. I can try and, like, see how it goes out. Trying always makes a difference. Remember to see a silver chance on the out.